It was like dark. It was like the night has come over during daytime.
When they came in, into our country, never could quell the spirit of freedom among the people.
I remember him being angry when a little boy was shot by the police. This boy died in hospital in his hands. He said to me, "You know what, Mamande? If ever this policeman will kill me, really, I promise you today, I will never leave him to rest. I will haunt them each and every day."
Matthew was a visionary. He was a dedicated medicine science teacher who brought the excellent results. And he introduced discipline in the school to the admiration of the community. Yeah. A model revolutionary, that's what he was.
There was a big search, né, where they have put on these searchlights and on the mountains and things like that. It was early in the morning. It was about 4 a.m. or 3 a.m. And they were looking for documents and papers and things. And at a later stage, Venter came into my room and he was like seated on my bed. And he asked me, "Mrs. Qalata, where is your husband?" And I said to him, "My husband is not here, he's in Johannesburg." And then he said to me, "You can hide him anyway, but tell him I will get hold of him. And when I get hold of him, he will shit himself."
There was bound to be an uprising. The area was semi-liberated.
You could see in the people that something big happened.
Democracy was bought at a high price, very high price. They are walking free, the murderers among us. That's what Simon Wiesenthal wrote about the Holocaust. We must never forget what happened to this country.